From the Digital Media Center on the campus of Southern Oregon University in Ashland, Oregon. This is Ramping Up Your English, an educational program for intermediate level English language learners. Here's your host for Ramping Up Your English, John Letts.
Welcome to Ramping Up Your English, winner of the Southern Oregon Television Award for Program of the Year and the Award for Best Educational Program. I'm the host and producer, John Letts. Ramping Up Your English is an educational support program for intermediate English learners. It's a program for people from all language backgrounds. Ramping Up Your English is also for people of all ages. If you've already passed the beginning stages of learning English and want to reach higher levels of proficiency, this program is designed to meet your needs. We take a content-based approach to helping you reach higher levels of English proficiency. Our current thematic unit is animals. This is segment one of episode 65. Most people are fascinated by the ocean. Perhaps it's the fact that our oceans are the cradle of life on our planet. Or maybe it's the way the ocean engages so many of our senses. It's such a different place than places where most people live. Besides engaging our imagination, the edge of the ocean is where many people find deep rest and healing. Sometimes the ocean can seem devoid of life, but we know better than that. What forms of life live under those waves? It's said that we know more about the surface of the moon than we do about our own oceans. From the coast of Oregon, we enjoy sweeping views of our Pacific Ocean. Well, our great views often include ocean animals like seals and sea lions. In our last episode, we learned about seals and sea lions. Then we listed adaptations of harbor seals, followed by a list of how those adaptations gave harbor seals an advantage in their marine environment. We used the connecting words and phrases that put these facts together in a way that shows cause and effect relationship between the facts. In this episode, we'll take a closer look at those connecting words, and we'll learn some more about this whole concept of adaptations. We'll also learn about other marine mammals. Now, in our last segment, we listed five physical adaptations that harbor seals have. Then we listed the advantages that are gained by having these adaptations. We showed how to connect those facts in a way that shows a cause-effect relationship. Let's quickly review how we did that. Notice the words in large print. Those are the connecting words that show that you're drawing a cause-effect relationship between the facts. Harbor seals have powerful hind flippers, which allows them to swim fast so they can catch prey and escape predators. Now we work with the second adaptation we identified. The small head allows smooth movement through the water. The eyes are large, permitting good vision in low light conditions. Now for that blubber. An insulating layer of blubber beneath the skin keeps the seal warm in cold water. And now those sensitive ears. I use the verb helping to avoid overusing the word allow. I also use the verb facilitates as the connecting word to the effect. Then I added more detail. Mother seals produce milk that's very high in fat content, facilitating rapid growth, especially the growth of blubber that conserves the pup's body heat in cold environments. Now, here's a list that has those connecting words. The first two on the list are the most common for the function of linking cause and effect when it comes to an animal's adaptations. The word allow or allows can be used in several ways with other words. The other common connector is the phrase so they can. Now, you can also use the phrase in order to. The other connecting words can be a great help when listing several adaptations. You never want to overuse a word or phrase. The words permitting and facilitating can also be used, as well as the phrase helping them or helping it, depending on whether you use the singular or plural form. These connecting words can be found on my website. Go to letscreate.org and navigate to the episode 65 page. That's where you'll find the list. You can also use these connecting words to illustrate the cause-effect relationship in the physical adaptation section of your report on the animal of your choice. Now, these key words and phrases are critical to communicating a cause-effect relationship. What could be more central to science? Science can be seen as exploring and testing the relationship between cause and effect. Now, you may think of science as being an academic matter or a professional concern. Well, it is both of those. But science, the tested and true relationship between cause and effect, is critical to our role as citizens of our community, nation, and world. There are a lot of so-called facts being communicated through social media, misinformation and falsehoods designed to trick us into supporting those who are working against our interest and the health of our communities. There are some very dark agendas being carried out, and they depend on sowing confusion in the minds of people. Now, this situation has made it impossible for us to have a national discourse on issues that matter. From Russian hackers to TV networks masquerading as news outlets, many people in the United States, including political leaders, are embracing beliefs that have no relationship to reality. The antidote to this dangerous situation is a skeptical approach. Is there a true cause-effect relationship between the pieces of information we're given? It's like my old biology professor insisted we ask the question, where's the proof for that? Now, science can often isolate a cause-effect dynamic even when multiple causes and effects are in play. When we're finished with this science unit on animals, we'll tackle a social studies unit. Multiple causation and effects are common when looking at human affairs. Indeed, simplistic explanations are always suspect. A social studies unit will be coming up soon, but meanwhile, we're continuing with our study of animals. This episode has us exploring physical adaptations. It's a fair question to ask why these are called adaptations instead of just physical features. The concept of adaptations recognizes very slow changes that occur to living organisms over time. When conditions were different on Earth, ancestors of today's seals may not have had that layer of fat that today's animals need for colder water. Each generation has some amount of variability, just as we can see with people. So as the water got colder, those seal ancestors with a little extra fat survived, whereas the others in their population with less fat didn't. So those with that extra fat survive long enough to reproduce, bringing more fat seals into the population. As environmental pressures increased, those with the most fat survived to pass on their genes, and now all seals have the required amount of blubber to live in their cold water environments. Thus, the layer of blubber is an adaptation to a changing environment. If you followed that explanation, done without any visual clues, then your English listening proficiency is getting strong. If you're left wondering what in the world I was talking about, keep watching Ramping Up Your English. Your listening skills will continue to grow, and you'll reach higher levels of English proficiency. This ends segment one of episode 65.